Dimensional analysis, dual unit conversions. We have dual unit conversions. It just means that we have to convert two units. We have one unit in the numerator and one unit in the denominator. Per is the fraction bar or division bar that we think of with a fraction. With dual units, we convert one unit at a time, meaning that you either want to focus on your unit that's in the top and take care of it, and then do your denominator, or vice versa. So let's take a look at example one. In example one, we need to convert 100 feet per second to miles per hour. So let's get feet to miles. That's what we're looking for first. And I happen to have a conversion for that. That 5,280 feet equals 1 mile. Okay, now that I have that one, we need to go from seconds to hours. We don't actually have one that goes from seconds to hours, but we can do seconds to minutes. So we have that 60 seconds equals 1 minute. And then we can go from 60 minutes equals 1 hour. Okay, now that I have all my conversions laid out to get me through this, I'm going to start with what they gave me, which is the 100 feet per second. So I write this as 100 feet per, there's my fraction bar, over my 1 second. Now I'm going to start with my feet to convert that one. So I have feet in the top, so I want to put feet in the denominator. And that means my mile will go up top. So my feet is gone, and I'm left with mile, which is what we want. Okay, so I can cross that one off. Now I have seconds in the denominator, and I want to convert that to an hour. So let's go to our conversion with seconds in it. And 60 seconds is going to go up top, and our minute is going to go in the denominator. So seconds is gone, and I can cross that conversion off. Now I have minutes and I need to go to hours. So a minute's in the denominator, so we're going to put minutes in the numerator. Now my minutes is gone, leaving me with miles per hour, which is what I need. So when I plug this into my calculator, I'm going to have 100 divided by 5,280 times 60 times 60. And that's going to give me 68.18, and I have a repeating decimal, so I'll call that a 2. And we'll say that this is miles per hour. Let's look at our second conversion. We need to convert 8 miles per hour squared to feet per second squared. Well, the miles is easy to take care of. We know that in 1 mile, we have 5,280 feet. Now, when we have this squared part, we don't have a conversion for that. So what that means is that we're going to use our conversions twice to get them squared so that we have hour times hour, which would give us hour squared, or seconds times seconds, which would give us seconds squared. So we're starting with an hour. We know that 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes, and that 1 minute equals 60 seconds. Now I'm not writing my conversion down twice here. I'm going to use that for when I'm actually converting. I just want to have my conversions easily visible for me to look at. So starting with what we were given, which is the 8 miles per hour squared, We have 8 miles over 1 hour squared. Converting my miles first, I'm going to put my mile in the denominator, my 5,280 feet in the numerator. My miles now are gone, and I can cross that conversion off. Now, I have 1 hour squared, which means I have 1 hour times 1 hour to get that to be squared. So I wanted my hours in the top. That means my minutes go in the denominator. And my hours squared can be crossed off. Now I'm going to put my next conversion into place. I have minutes in the denominator, and I have it in there twice, so I want to put minutes twice in my numerator, and then put my 60 seconds twice in my denominator. So when I plug this into my calculator, I'm going to have 8 times 5,280 divided by 60, divided by 60, divided by 60, divided by 60. Let's see, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and I have 4 here, so I'll make sure that I've got all the numbers. So I'll plug that into my calculator and I'll get 0.003259, and this is going to be feet per second squared.